there is a higher level of iman, an iman with an intellectual dimension, having an intellectual insight into iman. This is the highest level of iman. And let me quote here. This is ayah number 108 of Surah Yusuf, alayhi salatu wassalam. The Prophet was commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to proclaim, Qul, proclaim O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Qul hazihi sabili, adu ilallahi, ala basiratin ana wa man ittabani. Proclaim, this is my path. I am calling you to Allah, but not groping in the darkness. Ala basiratin ana. With the clear insight, I am seeing it from my internal eyes. Not only me, also my companions. وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, whosoever is following me, is not a blind follower. He is following me عَلَى وَجْهِ الْبَصِيرَةِ. This is the highest level of iman. And mind you, this is the iman that is needed today. The intellectual level of humanity has gone very high. Now the teenagers, their level of consciousness is more than the level of consciousness of the grown-ups of the past. There's an explosion of knowledge. And unless you can integrate this knowledge with faith, with iman, your next generation is not going to keep it. They are not going to follow you blindly. That is the most important point. Faith is faith. Whether blind, I accept it. Whosoever has it, his character will be transformed. He will be successful on the day of judgment. I don't say it's useless. No. Only what you need is the depth, the burning faith, the deep faith, the living faith. That should be the. But it's not necessary that you should have intellectual element also, the insight also, the hikmah also, the wisdom also. This hikmah, you know, this wisdom. Quran says, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. And this is the highest level of the education of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هُوَ الَّذِي بَعْثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. This is the specialization level of the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. The Prophet said, for whomsoever Allah intends something good, He gives him an insight in the deen. Tafaqquh, the understanding, deep understanding, and the deep insight. So actually, that is the burning need of the day. Now please, there are three modes of getting iman. Number one, the easiest way, keep company of those who have real faith. Be near them. Iman will flow from their personalities to yours, from their hearts to yours. There are invisible channels. Now you believe in ESP, extrasensory perception. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in ayah number 119 of Surah At-Tawbah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullah wa kunu ma'as sadiqeen. If you sit in front of a fire furnace, you get the warmth. If you are sitting near, you know, some block of ice, you are getting the coolness. If you are in the presence of a sahibul iman, having real, burning, living, deep iman, you will have iman. But this is passive iman. You are getting it passively. And number two, it will not have the intellectual element. The second mode, practicing. Practice Islam. Go on praying 5 times a day. Go on fasting. Not only the month of Ramadan, also have nafl form. 3 in every month or 2 every week. Spend for the cause of Allah. Give it away in charity, in alms to the poor. There is, you know, a bilateral process. Iman results in good deeds, and good deeds also result in iman. You know the word vicious circle? Vicious circle is something wrong and bad giving to some wrong result, then that result, bad result, adding to that something wrong, and goes on like a screw, progressing forward. Now you have a converse, you know, circle. Have little iman, practice it. You will have more iman. Then you will have more practice. You will have more iman. Then you will have more practice of iman, Islam. So this is also, and actually, this has been said in Surah Al-Hujurat. You know, the discussion on Islam and iman, the most important part of the Quran is the last 5 ayat of Surah Al-Hujurat. And you know the last but one ayah, what does it say? يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ أَنْ أَسْلَمُوا. These peoples who are claiming to be Mu'mins are not, and are not Mu'mins, but only Muslims. But as I told you, not Munafiq also. But they are showing that they have done something good to you, O Muhammad, that they have become Mu'min or Muslim. So, O Muhammad, we have surrendered without fighting. So you must give us more from the sadaqat and zakat. يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ مَنَّا يَمُنُّو. Do you know, have some moral right over the other? يَمُنُّونَ عَلَيْكَ نَسْلَمُ قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّوا عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Tell them, don't have this, you know, ihsan on me. Don't show that you have done me some ihsan, some good deed to you, me. But Allah says that He has done good to you. He has shown you the path to iman. Hadakum lil iman. You can reach iman now through practice. In tuti'u Allah wa rasulahu la yalidkum min amalikum shay'a. If you continue obeying Allah and His Rasul, then you will be practicing, and this practice of Islam will give you real iman. So that is the second mode of getting iman. This also will be without any intellectual element, but it is active. You have to do something. You have to get it through action, through practice. While the first was passive, be in the society, be close to them, be in the company of those who have real iman, you will get it. It was passive and non-intellectual. It is active and also non-intellectual. But the last is how to get the real iman, which is active as well as has the intellectual element. The only source is the Quran. Ponder over it. Think over it. Recite it. Hammer it into your own personality. Deeper and deeper. because it gives you arguments. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Here iman comes with intellectual element. If you understand it. If you are only reciting it without understanding, but that is the practice, that is the second mode. Here you have to have tadabbur on it. وَتَدَبَّرُوا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِ الْأَقْفَالُهَا. So these are, this you know reality, a very big truth, was very plainly enunciated by Maulana Zafar Ali Khan in his beautiful couplet. وہ جنس نہیں ایمان جسے لے آئیں دکانے فلسفہ سے. ڈھونڈے سے ملے گی عاقل کو یہ قرآن کے سپاروں. You need to be an aqil, to be an intellectual. You apply your intellect to the Quran. Then you have the topmost variety of iman. And that is the active iman with an intellectual element, with an insight, with the wisdom, with the tafaqquh. And that is, as I said, that is actually the need of the day. And the only source, mind you, the only source is Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is ayah number 9 of Surah Al-Hadid. هُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. It is He, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is sending down His ayat bayyanat, His clear signs, the ayat of Quran, sending down them to His slave, to His bondsman, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What for? So that He brings you out, help of these ayat of Quran, from all shades of darkness, from the kufr, from the shirk, from the ilhad, from materialism, from logical positivism, from agnosticism, from all these things, atheism. This Quran, ayat-e-bayyinat, they will take you out gradually. يُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. يُخْرِجُكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. هُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ آيَاتٍ بَيِّنَاتٍ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Only these ayat-e-bayyinat of the Quran can take you out from all shades of darkness into light of iman. Real iman, burning iman, living iman, deep iman, intense iman. And let me give another. This is the ayat of Surah At-Taghabun, ayah 8. فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالنُّورِ الَّذِي أَنزَلْنَا. Have real faith in Allah and His Messenger and the light that we have sent down. This is light, this Quran. But there are two lights. One is this physical light with which we see the external world. This light of sun, maybe it is of sun, or maybe it is of moon, maybe it is of electricity. You know, this is physical light. And we cannot see without it. If the lights are put off, you will be there, I am here. But you will not be seeing me, I will not be seeing you. This is the necessary medium of seeing the external realities. There is an inner light necessary to see, the necessary medium, to see the hidden facts, the ghaib, and that light is Quran. فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالنُّورِ الَّذِي أَنزَلْنَا وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Whatever you are doing, Allah knows everything. I must end up here. I wanted to give something very precious more, but I have to finish this talk now. Maybe I include that portion in my next lecture tomorrow. What was the type of iman that Sahaba had? And what type is the iman that we can have today? بارك الله لي لكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.